Hello, welcome to this week's subscription coffee tasting. Today we're going to be looking at a washed Catuai by a Peruvian coffee farmer, Lucero Torres. This is a coffee that was sourced for us by our long-term coffee partners, Falcon Speciality, so thank you for that. When I opened the bag of coffee, I was met by this really heady aroma of fruit. So that then led me into my strategy for roasting the coffees this week. One that was designed to emphasize those fruit characteristics. So for that, I was trying to access a roast time of around 10 minutes. I performed 4 batches this week to meet the order requirements for our subscribers and to have coffee available for our e-commerce customers and for those who purchase from us at Beverly Market every Saturday. So as I approached the 4 batches, my idea was that batch number 1, I would apply enough energy and heat early on in the roast cycle to try and get to 10 minutes of total roast time with a post-first crack development of somewhere about a minute and a half to a minute 40. That, for me, minute and a half is a fairly short development time for me. Our local water profile is such that we have a very high level of calcium carbonate, and a lot of my customers will maybe not be filtering their water, something that we really should talk about in the future, and something that if you don't already filter your water, please do. So with having high levels of calcium carbonate in the water, we're going to run the risk of a muted cup, and I need to make sure that the coffees that I roast are going to be highly soluble for those people. So generally, I don't get roast any quicker development time than a minute and 30 seconds, and broadly speaking, it's somewhere between a minute 30 and maybe a minute 50. So 20 seconds is quite a long time, but it depends on what coffee I'm working with. It depends on the underlying moisture content of the coffee, the size of the beans, the density, all those sorts of things. And maybe too, although I like to try an omni-roast, sometimes I feel that a coffee would have a leaning towards espresso or a leaning towards filter. And I'll use that understanding to try and give me a direction in the roast and help me build a recipe before I actually get into the batch. So I've done 4 batches. Batch number 1 is somewhere close to 10 minutes, and batch number 4 is pushing about 10 minutes and 30 seconds. And I tried then to have a 10 second increase in roast time for each of the 4 batches, with post first crack development between 1 minute 30 and 1 minute 40. So I was hoping, based on that heavy fruit characteristic in the green coffee sack, to really emphasize that fruity character in the cup. And let's hope that we see that on the cupping table today. Next, I'll taste the coffee. And as I described last week, I'm going to look at the 3 buckets of how I describe flavor. So acidity and language around that, mouthfeel and finish, and are there any descriptors that would describe this harmony of flavors in the cup? So let's get into cup number 1. So with this, I'm getting a really juicy orange, quite sweet, but that orange, that citrus is very, very prevalent in the cup. It definitely is juicy. It's not something that is particularly sour or sharp, because there's this sweetness that is in there, and just so juicy in the cup. As a preliminary guess, I would say that this is going to be a coffee that's going to be well suited to filter brewing. Next, I'll talk about the body and how that feels on my mouth. So let's just get it stuck in. So this is a light medium body. But one that's got a really lovely coating on the mouth. I'm actually getting a little bit of the finish through at this point, and it's that finish, which I'll come to in a second, that is really emphasizing this, um, this coating mouthfeel. So that finish is very much on the treacle, golden syrup, that type of end of the spectrum. And that then adds to this coating mouthfeel that I have. This coffee would be exceptionally well suited to filter coffee brewing, but would also be well suited to full immersion or espresso. If I had a preference, I would be in that filter brew camp. For those of you that do use this or do brew coffee as a cafetiere, that treacle will come through really lovely. You'll then get that pep up from the juicy orange, and same with your espresso. Lots of juicy orange in the cup, nice and bright and youthful. So maybe if you're a person who hasn't yet purchased this coffee and you're looking for one that that is heavy and rich for your espresso brewing, this may not be the coffee for you, but those of you who enjoy that sparkle in the cup, this will be an absolute delight. So to recap, this is a washed catuí from a Peruvian coffee farmer, Lucero Torres. It is a coffee that I would strongly say is well suited to filter brewing, one that anybody who enjoys fruit-forward coffee would really enjoy. So those of you who are going to receive this as your subscription coffee this week, I hope that you enjoyed this fruit-forward washed coffee from Peru. And for those who haven't yet purchased it, and ones that enjoy fruity coffee, this is going to be right up your street. Once again, I really hope you enjoy the coffee and have a great week.